Hey, this is Zelitz. The news came in the other week that Danny Boyle has exited directing Bond 25 over the always mysterious creative differences. And as a Bond fan, I'm frustrated. It's not that Boyle is any all-time favorite director of mine. I like 127 Hours and Slumdog Millionaire and Steve Jobs just fine, but I've also only seen them once each, and it's not like I go back to them again and again or anything. But I've been holding on to a more broad rant about Eon Productions and the state of Bond in general for like a year now, and I feel like I just have to speak up at this point and tell Eon and Barbara Broccoli and Michael G. Wilson to get their shit together. I understand that making a movie is hard work, but it does not and should not take 4 years, five if Bond 25 gets delayed, years at a time, to make a two-hour action-adventure movie about a secret agent with a gun and a cool car. And it didn't used to. Back in the golden era James Bond days, the 60s, 70s, 80s, Gubby Broccoli and Harry Saltzman got those films churned out every year or two, again, and again, and again, and again. Not even missing a beat when they had to replace actors, with Majesty's Secret Service, Live and Let Die, and The Living Daylights coming out 2 years on the dot, after losing Connery twice and Roger Moore after their preceding films. The ship kept moving forward, and they kept churning out, in my opinion, mostly great Bond films, even raising the bar with stunts and special effects as the series went on, and in the films lighter on effects like For Your Eyes Only and the two Timothy Dalton films, upping their game on the script front. And if there was a lesser entry, no problem. Just give it 730 days or so and another one will be hitting theaters. But that was then and this is now. We're just on the cusp of being 3 goddamn years out from Spectre, and now we don't even have a director, and the state of Bond 25 and whether or not it's even going to hit its original 2019 release date is entirely in flux. And I'm sorry, but that's laughable. 3 years out from Dr. No, or I guess I should say the world, since I was still decades from being born, but the world had already seen the conception, writing, pre-production, filming, editing, and release of From Russia With Love, Goldfinger, and Thunderball, with at least the first two of those films being a hell of a lot better than Spectre. And here's the sad thing. 6 years back, Skyfall marked literally the best opportunity the series has ever had since Connery left for the world of cinema to see a return to the full-blown Bond mania of the 60s. Fucking everyone saw Skyfall. It was the 7th highest grossing film of all time back when it came out. It beat Batman and the Hobbit at the box office that year. $1 billion box office, Oscar nominations and wins for the first time in decades, critical acclaim, 4 stars from Roger Ebert fan popularity, normie popularity, huge DVD sales, and an ending that set up the true classic James Bond character with M and Q and Moneypenny back in the classic MI6 office, padded door and all. The iron was so hot for the series to lean on the success establishing this character's new origin story in Casino Royale and Skyfall, ditch the serialization and political subplots and going rogue, and this time it's personal, get back on a 2-year cycle of fun, standalone, episodic adventures in the spirit of Live and Let Die, Goldfinger, Spy Who Loved Me, You Only Live Twice, Tomorrow Never Dies. But instead, 6 years out, 6 years. 7th graders who saw Skyfall in theaters are in college now. All we've got is one more Bond film, Spectre, that leaned into all the worst instincts of all that going rogue, and this time it's personal, and Star Wars, Marvel, wannabe, serialization, and political subplots. Oh, sweet Christ, the political subplots. I'm so done with all these M scenes at MI6. What Skyfall did with Judi Dench's M should have been the series' final statement on that. And now nothing. Endless stretches of nothing, not even any Bond video games, and now no director for Bond 25, and all the momentum from Skyfall is gone. And it's not the best time for Bond to fade from the public consciousness either, especially right after Mission Impossible Fallout quite frankly blew Spectre out of the water, and that definitely hasn't always been the case. I like 1996 Mission Impossible, seen it a few times, but GoldenEye was still 10 times the movie it was, and I've seen it 10 times as many times. I also like J.J. Abrams' Mission Impossible 3 in 2006, but Casino Royale eviscerated a few months later, not even close. Tomorrow Never Dies isn't a masterpiece, but it's still easily more entertaining than Mission Impossible 2, and despite great stunt work and the fun, playful vibe of Ghost Protocol, the visual majesty and emotion and risk-taking of Skyfall still did a lot more for me personally. But Tom Cruise and Chris McQuarrie have raised the game this time out, and the stunt work and twists and excitement of Fallout just smears Spectre across the windshield. The Halo jump, the bathroom fight, the final helicopter scenes, some of the best action scenes in years. I was sitting there watching that amazing Paris motorcycle chase, Tom Cruise going full Trinity from The Matrix Reloaded, riding lightning speed against traffic, and I couldn't not think, damn, why wasn't that Rome car chase in Spectre more like this? And even though Fallout's plot is ultimately just about stopping a nuke, no different than we've seen in Bond films like Octopussy, the plotting was much more exciting here than Spectre, and didn't have some stupid twist about Foster Brothers. A spy action movie gauntlet has been thrown down here, and I'm frankly terrified that Eon is going to bring back Neil Purvis and Robert Wade as writers, two names that, despite what they were able to accomplish with the help of Ian Fleming's original text, and Paul Haggis and John Logan in Casino Royale and Skyfall, I've grown to hate seeing in the credits. They're the worst sort of creatives, one who think they're innovators when they're actually hacks, unless they have the strictest guidance, and they keep trying to give us the same blend of going rogue, and this time it's personal, and a personal connection to the villain, and the MI6 regulars in the field, and political subplots, and if they come back, we're probably going to see all that again. And frankly, I don't ever need to see Bond going rogue again. Certainly not for at least, like, 6 films. Purvis and Wade have also waded, as so much of the entertainment industry, into cringy political commentary lately, and publicly lamented about how to make a Bond film in the age of Trump and so on, and I need a woke James Bond film like I need my fucking nutsack in a meat grinder. There are literally 1,000 screenwriters out there who would be more than happy to take a crack at Bond, and we do not need the same 2 guys on writing duty for what next year will have been 20 fucking years since they debuted with The World Is Not Enough in 1999. Hell, if Eon really wants legacy writers, as far as I can tell from IMDb, Bruce Feirstein, who wrote GoldenEye, Tomorrow Never Dies, is still alive and well, and even wrote story and dialogue for 5 James Bond video games going all the way back to Everything or Nothing in 2003. Why don't you try finding his number, Eon? I'm really not here to shit on Barbara Broccoli and Michael G. Wilson, because together with the help of Martin Campbell, they produced 2 of my favorite films of all time in GoldenEye and Casino Royale, 2 movies I've watched over and over and over through the years. I don't know if they're the problem or if Daniel Craig and his apparently heavily influential hand in the direction of the last few films is the problem. I'd blame a perfectionist instinct if this was a long delay after the relatively artistically minded Skyfall, but having seen Spectre, I don't think perfectionism is the problem. But these huge delays, even as other series put out a steady stream of content every year or at least every other year, and lost directors, and lack of creative direction, endlessly repeating themes, and hiring the same 2 hack screenwriters over and over, it's just frustrating. If Barbara and Mukherjee are bored and don't want to make Bond films anymore, then I'll say it. It's time to sell Eon Productions to another producer or studio or whoever that will put in the work and get back on a 2-year schedule. Either that, or I'd just like to entreat the Dark Gods to revive Cubby Broccoli and Richard Maibaum so they can put this shit back on course. And thanks for listening. I'll talk to y'all later.